Updating Joomla keeps hackers away. Why I wanted to spend some of your precious time in sunny Barcelona while speaking about this subject? Because keeping website up to date, or keeping websites up to date, is important for website owners, it's important for people who manage websites, it's important for users who use these websites, and it's also important for the entire Joomla community. So, who am I to tell you about this? My name is Aleksander, and I'm from Poland. I'm a self-made developer, and I've spent last 15 years, so exactly half of my life, building websites, mostly in Joomla. Then I became an extension developer, and recently, today is my 1 year anniversary involvement in Joomla community. I'm a part of JET team, so if you have anything good or bad to say about the new extension website, I'm more than happy to hear what you have to say and pass it on to the rest of the to the leadership of the team. And I'm also a bit of a hacker, because when I was a teenager back in high school, my parents bought me a book by American hacker Kevin Mitnick named The Art of Deception. And I've read it overnight, and I couldn't resist the temptation to try it on my own. So I started to watch closely on the schedule of our school IT server administrator. And when he left for a conference, then I spoofed an email that seems to be sent from him, or pretended that it was sent from our server administrator, saying that the school server has been hacked, and all the database has been acquired by hackers, and now they're trying to decrypt all the passwords to get inside. So we need to change all the passwords, and that's why it's important for you users, the email said, to send us logins and current passwords so we could change them before a hacker will be able to decrypt the database. And in the next 24 hours, I've got all, maybe not all, but more than a half of passwords, but all the passwords from teachers and even the school principal. Well, it was then hard for me not to get thrown out from the school, but it learned me one very very important thing, that when it comes to hacking, it's not always about software. It's usually about the people, and the people usually are the weakest link, and Kevin was absolutely right. I tested on, you know, my own case, and it really works like this. Today I'll be talking more about the software vulnerabilities, but I wanted to start with this example so that you remember that it is not only about the software, and the software is not the only thing you should keep in mind while thinking of website security. So, a lot of data I'll present today is based on Perfect Dashboard. That's the platform that we have developed recently to help website administrators save their time on their extraordinary and ordinary tasks. And I'm not here to brag about it, but I just want to tell you that we have a large data sample that we can use in the moment, because we have over 2,000 web developers managing their websites using this tool, and several thousand of websites using hundreds of extensions. So we really can see how it's working, because we have indirect access to every of this website, and we see how often they're updated, which extensions they use, how those extensions are being updated, what's the quality of the updates, what's the manner of delivering updates, and that's the things I want to share with you today. So you can better understand why it's so important to work in a certain way to make Joomla websites up to date. But so I've told you a little bit about myself. You already, well, most of you were able to say your name, so I'm happy to know you. But now I have some more questions, and I think it would be nice to do a little bit of exercise, as it's still in the morning. So would you all please stand up for a while? And I would like to ask you if you could please remain standing, if you have visited at last one website today. So, if you haven't been on any website today, no matter using your browser or mobile browser or browser in your computer, please still remain standing. Okay. So, most of you, that's the usual result I get when I see. And then, okay, so who has at least one website? Please still remain standing. Yeah, I know that you may have some. Okay. Okay, and who manage at least one website? Who is responsible for keeping it updated and everything? Then please remain standing. Then, if you have more than five websites that you manage, please remain standing. More than five websites. Yeah, I know that they may be difficult for you, actually. So, if you manage more than 10 websites, please remain standing. If you manage more than 15 websites, more than 20, more than 25, okay, more than 35. Okay, more than 50. Okay, so I won't tell you what the current record is, but I'll ask you, how many websites? Okay, that's impressive about you.
Well, I work for a hosting company, so technically it's about 15,000.
Okay, so I think that it does not count, but congratulations for you. And how about you, sir?
Something around 70.
Okay. So, up till today, the current record belongs to Davide Maserini from Italy, who managed himself 180 websites.
Cool.
I'm still wondering how he managed to do that before we started working with him. But the one story I heard from him is that, you now may take your place. Sorry, thank you for working with me on that. So, when I asked Davide one time, if a security update would be released tomorrow, how long would it take him to update all the websites he managed? And his answer after a little bit of computation was 11 days. So think of it. You know, a security update, serious thing.
Is it about the update or it's automatic?
Well, it was about his workflow at time. Of course, it has improved, and I'll show you some ideas how the management workflow can be improved today. But just to give you an impression. And he thought that 30 minutes per website is enough. And from my personal experience as a former web administrator, well, it rarely is. So, why updating Joomla is crucial? Because, you know, everybody's saying it's important to be up to date and, you know, blah, blah, blah. We hear it all the time, but actually, what's the reason behind it? And there are some of them. So, first of all, websites are the new hacker's favorite. In the past, it was emails. Emails were the best channel to send the malicious code to the users who were opening those emails and trusting like those who trusted the email I've sent. They were trusting that this photo or this PDF attachment or this Word file with some macro installed is a safe thing, and they'll get hacked this way. Now, it's all about websites. Websites are becoming more and more popular among hackers as a tool. And the second thing is that usually websites are only a gateway. Because unless you have a very interesting data in your database, unless you have a credit card hashes in there, which is unlikely, unless you earn a lot of money on the advertisement that can be taken away from you, your websites are not really interesting, and your clients' websites are not a really interesting thing for hackers. They are only interesting as a gateway to the real goal, which are users. Which are users, their phones, their computers, because that's where the interesting data is. Because on our phones and in our computers, we have plenty of interesting things. And of course, most of the users' computers are quite secure, but still there are quite many of them were using an outdated Android systems or still using Windows XP, definitely in large companies. So that's what hackers are looking for. They're not looking for your website or websites that you manage. They just want to go through using this website as a gateway. And keeping websites up to date is the one simplest thing you can do in order to make your website updated. Because nobody, or almost nobody, is hacking the website in order to hack this particular website. No, it's a mass action. It's an automated script going from one site to another looking for websites that are not up to date. So keeping yourself updated solves you 99.5% of problems. That's why keeping websites up to date is important. It's all about the security. And now let me show you, in the time that we were all listening to the keynote by Zev, my team in Poland was doing one nasty thing I want to share with you now. We have recorded that for you so you can see that clearly. How easy it is to hack a website? I'm not sure if you can see that in this light, but we're just launching our exploiter and we're going after some popular Joomla websites like JN Beyond, like Joomla.org, like Joomla.de, Joomla.fr, Joomla Netherlands, and some others. We have omitted Joomla.pl, don't worry. And as you see, most of them is up to date, so there is no obvious way to get into it. But then we've put one other on the list. I'd wait for the script to come to this point. And here we are. We detected it's Joomla 3.2.4. So the version that is 2 years old. Not a very old website. And using the well-known vulnerability in the sessions, we are able to exploit it and get the access to the database. Then we are able to create our own super admin user. And you know, in a flash, we can just go into the website and log in as a super administrator. It's, you know, as simple as that. And you can just keep such scripts running and you can just intercept as many websites as you want. And you don't even need to be a programmer, because usually that's how we end such things when we do it. So keep in mind that you can find those scripts online. You don't need to be a great developer to find to write those exploits yourself. You can find them on the internet. Then you can buy a cheap DigitalOcean server for $10 a month and run it and intercept and hack many websites. And it's not difficult. And as I told you, it's quite a popular version, taking in consideration that it has been fixed in Joomla 3.4.6. So every website that is older than 8 months, because I think that's the time from the release, will be vulnerable for that. So, you know, it's not a difficult thing, and that's the way hackers work. Because it's Joomla popularity that makes an attractive target for hackers. Because hackers are smart, usually. And they look for maximizing their effort while taking their actions. They're not interested in working long hours to hack one website. No, they want to get as many websites as possible in the most limited time. That's why they're using automated scripts as the one I've showed you. And that's why they're taking advantage of the monoculture, which are Joomla websites that use similar software, and still most of it is out of date. That's the problem, and that's what you should keep in mind, that the biggest assets of Joomla, so those millions that use it, is also in this case the biggest threat. And there is also one other important point I'd like to make. Because internet gives us a huge opportunity. We all know that we can spread across and reach out to almost unlimited number of people almost for free using the internet. But this opportunity comes with a price tag, with some responsibility. Because Imagine you have a brick and mortar store, a real store in the real world, and you have a slippery floor, just like this one. And you know, someone will slip on this floor and break his or her leg or twist her ankle. Everybody will take the website, the store owner accountable. Say, well, it's your responsibility to keep the floor in such a way that nobody will be able to slip on that, especially in the US, right, Robert? And you know, the same principles should apply to websites. Because if your website is not up to date and it possibly can be hacked, then it's possible that you are endangering your users. Because most of the hackers won't do it in such a way that they will display their big logo on the you know, first page to say, ah, you've been hacked by Syrian rebels or anyone else. Because you know, that's the way script kiddies do it. The professional hackers do it underneath. There's no slightest information that the website has been hacked. Because the longer the hack has been undetected, the better it is for the hacker, because he can still exploit the end users that visit this website. That's why you should keep in mind that every website is a responsibility, and all the websites that you manage that are not up to date are like the stores with the slippery floor that someone may broke his leg or twist her ankle. So take that in mind. Okay, so taking all of that into consideration, the biggest question I've got at this point is, why 80% of websites are out of date? So, because that's not a secret that I've already shared with you. We all know that it's important to keep websites up to date. So why it's not happening? Why it is like this? Any ideas?
I'd say mostly extension compatibility issues.
Yeah, that's one of the issues.
Extension compatibility.
Okay.
The overwrites.
Excuse me?
Overwrites that you want.
Yeah, that's true. All the changes, especially in the core, all the hacks that you should never make, but we all do them. I know. Or most of us that. Any other ideas or reasons?
No.
Yeah, that sometimes is also a problem. No matter, Joomla is providing a one-click update, and there are some solutions to solve that. For example, if you have an Akiba backup installed, then it even tries to make a backup together with this update. And yeah, that's true. That updating is a pain, and you know, it's a lengthy and it's boring procedure, and it's a time-consuming thing because. To be honest, I don't agree with Davide Maserini, I quoted earlier, that you are possible to update a website in 30 minutes. When I calculated the average time it took us in the company to update the website, an average website. No, taking all the procedure from the start till the website is fully operational again, it took us on average 4 hours to do that. And it's, well, it's not a fascinating job, isn't it? That's why the one simple solution to that is automation. Because most of the tasks that you undertake during the update can be automated. And that's the key to make your life easier and to increase the percentage of websites that are up to date. Because if you think of of the things that should be done within the update process, it's not only about installing the updates. That's only one of the things on the list. Because first you get to know that there is an update. Okay, there is a new core Joomla feature that will email you when there is an update in the core. That's great. But how about the extensions? For example, I know your extensions, and I know that you have a decent update policy, and you inform your users using, for example, the update servers. But there are quite a few developers that don't use update servers. And then there is no way to get information about the update being released, even the security one, because you know you had to visit their websites on a regular basis in order to know that. And even those who use the update servers often use it in the wrong way. For example, one of the biggest extension provider, OSMAP, the creators of Validia framework. They use update servers, that's great, but unless you provide the key, they won't even inform you that there is an update. So it's not only about they won't give you the update, because that's obvious, but they won't even display you an information that there is an update you should install. So that's the first thing. Then it's doing backups. Well, it seems to be simple. There are multiple solutions for that. But then it comes the third point, verifying the backup integrity. Because it's simple to do the backup, but from our statistics, we know that 1 out of 10 backups is not ready to be restored. You can't restore the website from this backup. That's why it's crucial not only to do a backup, but also to check the backup integrity. Because otherwise, you know, it's like you don't have backup at all. Then it's all about installing the updates. And here's the thing that both of you mentioned, so the compatibility issues, because not all of the extensions are usually compatible with the new version. And it's all usually it's very difficult to see to what version I can update in order to stay compatible with the extensions I have. And once we were creating the compatibility charts, I remember it was a real pain to discover, you know, what to which version of Joomla you can update certain extensions safely, because there is no good way to know that, apart from, you know, asking developers themselves or checking how it worked for other users. So that's definitely an issue. And then it's my worst pain, so testing the website. Because after everything is installed, then there's the question whether the website works or not, or something got broken or not. And sometimes the changes are quite subtle, but it's difficult, especially if you update the production server, which I don't recommend, but I know it's a common policy. It's difficult to see what actually has been changed. Because if the website is a total mess up, then yes, you know that something bad happened. But if it's not, if it's just a slight change of colors or styles or somewhere in the CSS, it's possible that you won't notice. But believe me, it's quite possible that your client will notice and you'll get an email or an angry phone within an hour asking why my website is different. So testing website is another thing that you should consider on the list. And to give you a solution for that, well, there are quite a few tools out there. I'm sure you're all familiar with Akiba, our ultimate backup solution that almost everybody is using. There is another sponsor of this event, Backup Monkey, which I think hasn't launched yet, but I decided to put them in here. And let's see whether they what they will be their offer for backup services. Then there is SiteGround. It's a hosting company, but they provide with the auto update. They provide the auto update feature. To be honest, I'm not a big fan of the idea, because if you manage websites yourself and you are a responsible web developer, web manager, and you update your website just after the especially the security update has been released, the automated update is not a solution for you because it comes without any backup before and without testing. So it's difficult for you to know whether it's okay or not and to just get surprised by it. However, for all those websites out there which are not updated, I think it's better that those websites, let's say, are broken but they're not infecting their visitors than the other way around. But guys from SiteGround has also their own solution. Then this cloud over there, My Joomla by Phil Taylor. They have also solutions to some of the problems I've listed on the previous slide. And of course, they are a great help to those who are already infected. And no matter they are my competitors, I always recommend Phil as a great place to go if your website has already been hacked, because he is a really great person when it comes to unhacking the website that has already been hacked. Then there is Watchfully, another suite for Joomla management that helps you for with doing updates, doing backups. So it's also worth considering. And I won't advertise my own product, but yes, we also solve the problems, all of them actually, on the list. So you know, feel free to browse these tools, and I'm sure you're familiar with some of them already, and they are solutions to most of those problems. Additionally, more help. You're always invited to go to our Facebook group. You don't need to be our user. There's no requirement for that. But there is plenty of experienced web administrators from all over the world there, and it's a good place to ask questions and you know, exchange some thoughts. And you know, seeing that some of you have a lot of experience themselves, I think that you can become a valuable asset there, and you can help a lot of people having issues with website management. We also give some document templates there and other pro tips from our experience and from the data that we acquire through Perfect Dashboard. So always free to join us, and that's the place you can find some information. Apart from that, there are some other sources that are worth visiting. Definitely Joomla Days and Joomla Conferences. That's another place I've heard a lot of ideas that were useful back then when I was a website administrator. And Joomla Conferences, and apart from Joomla Days, local Joomla events, if there are events like this in your countries, and of course global Joomla events like Joomla World Conference or JN Beyond, which is happening right now. Okay. Do we have a slide? No. So, there is one additional reason why website management should be interesting to you, because it's a great business. It's a better business than building websites, and the reason for that is very simple. If you look at the amount of time that is required to double your potential, it's much easier with website management than with creating websites. Because if you need to build another website, usually you need same amount of time that you used to build the first website. And if you want to double the number of websites you manage, you don't need the double amount of time for that. Because there is a lot of automation that can help you. And you can automate the work in such a way that the increase of your workload is not that high. And it's also something that you know you can expect every month to come into your bank account. So you're not starting every month from zero, and then you're trying to get some work done, and you're looking for work to create some websites, and every month you start from zero and you're looking for some jobs. In this case, you have the group of your clients that are paying you monthly. So, you know, you have the base you can build on. You are certain about the level of the income you're getting. So that's why it's a business model that is worth taking. Of course, it's possible to combine those two. You can have the certain number of websites that you manage that gives you a safe level of income that you have every month. And then you can do some extra work with regard to website development that will bring you some extra money for, you know, nice holiday, new car, or something like this. Okay, and there is one additional reason why Joomla should be updated. So it's not only because it's a responsible thing to do, it's not only because it's a good business that can bring you good money, but it's also important for the community. And let me paraphrase the former US president, John Fitzgerald Kennedy, and say, you know, my fellow Joomlers, you know, ask not what Joomla can do for you, but what you can do for the Joomla community. And keeping websites up to date is one of the best things that you can do to make Joomla community a better place and to help the entire Joomla project. Because, you know, I hear a lot of complaints from website owners all over the world and from website developers that they're saying that their customers don't want websites built with Joomla because they consider Joomla as a website that are easy to hack, which is apparently not true. I don't know if any of you have been to Joomla Day London, Joomla Day UK in London last February, but Brian Timman doing the presentation showed that some top UK security institutions use Joomla for their website. Because an updated Joomla website is a very secure solution that can be trusted. But an unsecured Joomla website, like the one that I showed you before, is so easy to hack that, you know, it's obvious why some people think it's a security threat. That's why if you keep your Joomla websites updated, you're doing good for the entire community because you're improving the reputation. And that's another thing that we can do, because I believe that, you know, only working together we can make internet a better place and we can increase the Joomla reputation. That's why today I want to recruit you. I want to recruit all of you, no matter you have a website on your own, because I want you to feel responsible for your users. If you manage websites, I want you to help me to make website owners to understand that they are responsible for their users and that possibly they need your help to make those users secure. If you create extensions, I want to recruit you so you spread the word about the updates and you use update servers in a proper way so that everybody can update your extensions. And of course, it's also a good thing for you from the business point of view. And then if you are involved in the community, I want to recruit you to spread the information of the importance of being up to date to your local communities, on your Joomla days, on your local Joomla groups. Because the more we'll talk about the issue, the bigger chance we have that we'll be able to increase the number of websites that are up to date, and it won't be again the 80% of outdated websites. That will go closer to 60, maybe 40%. And then we'll be able to increase the general image of Joomla as a reliable security, reliable and secure solution for all of us. So please join me in this crusade and let's try to change the image of Joomla in a positive way. Thank you. Okay, are there any questions?
What can we find the script to hack Joomla?
Well, try to Google for it. I won't send you our copy. You have a question.
What are your thoughts on how to deal with just data content between two separate instances and backing those up, not overwriting between, say, a staging instance and a production instance?
Well, that's a huge issue. That's true. And if you don't want to do it on the live server, which is a good idea, so let me just introduce the concept so that everybody understands what's the problem. If you're not updating the live website, so you're creating a separate test server and you're putting the copy of the websites there, it's possible that the website in production server, you know, is live website. So there are new posts published, there are new comments, for example, or if it's an e-commerce website, then there are transactions, anything. And in very short period of time, the database becomes incompatible. Because you, while doing the updates, usually it also amends the database. So you have one website, and you have two different versions of database. And none of them is a better version, because one has more live data, and the other one has, let's say, the more actual code for the more actual structure that is required by the newest version of Joomla. And as far as I'm concerned, there is no good solution for that. The best solution we have up to now is just to record, to log all the SQL queries that are created on the development server and then execute them on the database. But that's the best solution I found so far. Do you have any better?
We do similar, you know, writing out scripts that hopefully we can parse the tables out. So if it's core stuff, again, we try to do anything on the core side of things and push data to separate tables and then we can copy specific tables depending on the functionality.
That sounds also like a nice solution. There was one question over there, I thought.
Yes, any thoughts about how to restore all the websites that you manage in your passwords? And it's because you have to have in a situation password, FTP password. How can we store it? I have my own solution, but just go to...
Okay, so I'll ask you about your solution because I think it's important to share such ideas.
My solution is on email. So if I was hacked from my email,
Okay, so I'll give you our solution. We use password managers. There are two main password managers I know about. One is LastPass and the other one is 1Password. I think most of all of them have a free version when it comes to the web layer. So you need a mobile if you need a mobile application, you have to pay, but you can use it for free on the websites.
They have just only trial versions. It is all free.
I'm sure about LastPass because some of our employees use only the free version, and so I know it's free and it works.
1Password is not based on the web. So.
Yes, it is. There's now 1Password for Teams.
Yeah,
it's brand new, so it's.
Okay.
Yeah, but I'm we are using LastPass, and I know it does the work. And it's of course it's you know it's impossible to remember all the passwords if you are a web developer because for each website you have something I don't know like 6 or 7 different passwords starting from the FTP through the database to the backend panel and some other services like analytics or so. So yes, LastPass or any other solution similar to that is a great way to do that. And as we've been using LastPass for 5 years. And it has one security issue in the past, but it was the SSL problem that was a common thing, you know, among most of the software that has something to do with encryption.
There's also an open source password manager called KeePass. It also has a YubiKey integration, which plays pretty nicely if you're using YubiKeys for Joomla anyway.
Okay.
Yeah, that's good.
Question. Keeping Joomla updated is okay, but there are several more solutions or suggestions usually from Joomla and even any site owners just to have extended the HD access file with relative security issues. Also, it's possible to keep administrator URL as
different,
as unique or even limited the access by IP and a lot of solutions.
You know, it's true. Yeah, it all helps. That's true that, you know, keeping website up to date is a very basic level.
Yeah.
And there are several things you can do above that. I wasn't mentioning it because we still have a problem with the very basic level, as 80% of websites are out of date. But it's true that if you already have all your websites running Joomla 3.5.1, then it's great. And then you can think of installing some security software on it, limiting the access to certain APIs, doing the custom login page. It's all beneficial, and I do think it's a good idea. But if your websites are not running 3.5.1, then I suggest concentrate on that first and keeping all your extensions up to date as well, because that's one of the things I haven't said so far. 90% of security problems are not in the core itself. 90% of security problems are in the extensions. So keeping extensions up to date is a crucial thing, as well as keeping the core up to date. So once you've done with this, then I think it's a great idea to follow your advice and, you know, add another security layer on your website. I'm not sure if I get your question.
Website that uses e-commerce extensions, the other uses another access. So how do you keep it everything updates? So
well,
remember that you need to update every extension for this website.
That's the point. I should start my advertisement talk, so I won't. But to be honest, the only solution we found for that is to collect this information in one place so that you have all the extensions that you use on all your websites in one place and you see what's their update status. And if it's unknown, because sometimes it is, because not all websites, not all extension providers provide the information, then we just say to you, huh, my friend, we don't have any information neither from you, nor extension developer, nor any other Perfect Dashboard user, so please go to website to this website and check the version. Because once you do it, we'll share the information with the rest of the users and they will know that there is an update of this extension. So we use it in such a way, so we try to do some kind of community effort. Because we have many people working on our platform, so we can ask them, you know, could you please go and check? And they go and check. Of course, our staff do it as well. And in this way, we have a large database of information what extension require updates, even if there is no information in the backend panel. That's our approach. But to be honest, if you are on your own, yes, it is difficult, and we struggled with it. That's why we thought about this idea. Okay, so thank you very much for the session, and enjoy the rest of the conference.